Good morning. What a blessing it is to be here today and to be able to share life and to come together to seek the God who's already seeking us and who seeks to live in relationship with each of us and who calls us to live in a relationship of love with each other. What a blessing it is to be here at Wells Church. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Y'all don't sound very enthusiastic. Thank you, sir. Y'all know I've been to Jesse Robinson's birthday, so I'm expecting a little. It's all good. What a blessing it is to share life together. Thank you all for being here, and thank you those of you who are joining us virtually. What a joy it is to continue to share life with you as well, and we are grateful for you. This morning, there are a couple announcements. This week begins, our youth ministry is hosting the 8th graders from Operation Shoestring here at the church, which has become a wonderful, fun, and exciting time for us. Ashley would love to recruit anybody who may want to come help with food or crafts or whatever.
So, yeah, tomorrow we're tie-dyeing. Thursday we're doing like a messy games kind of. Like Jell-O in a bathtub might be a little extreme, but that we're gonna get gross. We're really excited about it. We have a new like gigantic slip and slide that I'm not sure what kind of thing will be put on it, but it'll be fun. So come and see what we're doing. We're really excited. It's only 15 kids, but we're really excited that it's a smaller group and we're gonna get to hopefully dig deeper. We've ordered Bibles for everyone, which we haven't done before, but since they're older. Again, we're kind of adjusting and moving, you know, just as the Spirit leads. So we're really, really thrilled about this week. So at any point between 9 and 1, if you want to come drop in, and you don't even have to lend a hand. You can just come sit by a teenager and hear their story and be someone in their life that's here to love on them. But from Monday through Thursday, 9 to 1, we'll be up here with those 8th graders.
Great. Did you want to say a word about the trip to Gatlinburg?
Sure. We are in the process of buying tickets and booking cabanas and solidifying our service work that we're doing, getting our tickets to Dolly Stampede, which the youth are kind of mortified but secretly thrilled to go see that show.
Me too.
Right?
Always.
So we still have some wiggle room. If there's anyone who hasn't already told me they want to come, but they have decided they want to come, we would love to add their name to our roster. But just be in prayer. We're really, really close to our fundraising goals. So if it's on your heart to donate in that way, we would appreciate it. And otherwise, just be in prayer. We have right now 12 youth and 3 adults who are going. So it'll be a great group.
Super. Yeah. Thank you so much. Upcoming is annual conference here in Jackson at Millsaps College. It will begin on the 20th and end on the 22nd. We're looking for anyone who may want to spend a few hours volunteering. You can come help out by greeting people, taking up money, all sorts of opportunities that are helping people park and find their way or whatever. So let Sue or I know if you're interested in that, and we'll be glad to direct you in the direction so you can sign up and do that. So if you are interested in that, I'm sorry, Ashley, go ahead.
So with annual conference on Friday, is it the mission worship service, right? It's part of the focus of it will be children and youth and college kids. So we've been asked if there are any youth or children or college age folks who would like to participate in that worship service. It's real easy. You kind of like run in and out. They're sharing, I think, a line of spoken text at the microphones, but Elizabeth will be there running in and out, and if there's anyone else who would like to be a part of that worship service, you can expect to be there for about an hour. But I would love to have some faces from Wells at that worship service.
Great. Mm-hmm. And already Elaine has mentioned help. Go ahead.
I'm going to make a detour to annual conference. This was going to be the first year in 13 that I wasn't going to be there, and then I signed us up for a booth in the vendor area for the Reconciling Ministries Network. And we are not going to have an RMN coordinator present, so we're doing this strictly with lay people this time. I need somebody on the afternoon of the 20th and the 21st to help staff the booth if you're free. That's at Millsaps. So give it a thought.
Great. And see Elaine if you're interested in helping with that. There is going to be on the 19th a potluck supper. And we're excited about that. It'll be your opportunity and my opportunity to share life together and to say goodbye to each other. It'll be kind of my retirement celebration as we celebrate Jubilee for those slaves in Texas who realized and were encouraged to be set free as kind of the last ones of those. So I think Chris and Sheila are looking for a year of Jubilee to come as well, and that to happen. So we're excited about that. Please do bring potluck things, and so we can share that together on the 19th. That will be at 6:30 here in the Taco Center as we share that in together. Are there other announcements that we need to make? Good. Let me share some birthdays that I know either just happened or about to happen or will happen before next Sunday. Wilson Jones has just had a birthday. So did Chris Gill, had a birthday this week. Dina Moore had a birthday end of the week as well. April Connor Bray. Olivia Perkins has one coming up, I think.
It was yesterday.
It was yesterday. That's right. Brenda Ferguson has one. Today, tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And Joan Ayers, Tawny Minton, Luke Mason has one this week. Matthew Arujo, Julie Donald, Catherine Henry. Our friend Ted Murray would have had a birthday this week as well. Jackie McGinnis shares one toward the end of the week along with Amanda Orgeron. And by next Sunday, Graham Williams would be having a birthday. And we celebrate that. He'll probably get another shout out next week too, but he'll smile then too, I bet. Won't you, Graham? That's exactly right. Wonderful. Any other birthdays? Yes.
My son's birthday is today.
Awesome.
My nephew Landon's birthday is the 14th, and my dad's stepmom's anniversary is the 14th, and
okay.
Then my sweet cat, Miss Beasley, is the 14th.
Okay. A lot of 14ths.
My granddaughter Lily's birthday is tomorrow.
All right.
My mother would have been 109 yesterday.
Wow.
And my friend Linda McGee's birthday is today.
Wow. Great. John?
My sister-in-law's husband, Lawrence Bontempo, who's a member of this church.
Right.
His birthday is June the 16th.
Oh, wow. Great. Great. Yes.
My mother's this week and my niece Catherine's as well.
Awesome. Happy birthday. Carol?
My granddaughter-in-law, Leilani McNulty's birthday.
Super. Any others? In the way of anniversaries, Chuck and Francine Reynolds celebrate an anniversary this week. Chuck, you want to share how many, or do you remember? Or?
21.
Awesome. We're grateful for that. And our friend Joy and Bob Gates would have celebrated an anniversary this week as well. And we remember that. Give thanks. Any other anniversaries or birthdays of sobriety dates that we want to celebrate the anniversary of today? What a blessing it is to be here and to share life. And I invite you, as you're able, to stand and join me in hymn number 454, Open My Eyes. I think.
Oh,
invite you to continue standing and join me in our call to worship. It can be found printed in your bulletin. Some of us come today with hearts weighed down with anxiety, fear, despair, and hurt. Together we cling to this truth. God's steadfast love endures forever. Some of us come today with hearts that feel light, with relief, joy, comfort, and gratitude. Together we cling to this truth. God's steadfast love endures forever. Some of us come today not knowing what we think about God, confused and disappointed that the world God made is so full of evils of every kind. Together we cling to this truth. God's steadfast love endures forever. Be with us, O God, and all that we bring with us as we gather to encounter your unchanging love. We come today to enter the dance of the Trinity, who is immutable in love. Amen. I invite you to continue standing and turn in your hymnal to page 883 as we join together in our affirmation of faith. As God's Spirit is leading you, I invite you to join me. We are not alone. We live in God's world. We believe in God, who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We are called to be the church, to celebrate God's presence, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus, crucified and risen, our judge and our hope, in life, in death, in life beyond death. God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God. Amen. You may now share signs of Christ's peace with one another.
The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. You may be seated.
Mercy.
As we prepare to go to God with our prayers, we certainly lift up the celebrations. As I mentioned, the Jesse Robinson birthday celebration, but also a chance to support Jesse through WellsFest Cares was incredible. It was good enough to make a preacher dance. Right, Gene Hawks? So, it was good stuff. And I had the privilege of dancing with some folks. The Parkers and Gene and I took the opportunity to cut a rug, so there you go. That's exactly right. Our friends the Parkers have headed toward the north today or yesterday, and so we say prayers for their moving travel and those sorts of things. As I spoke with Jeff, he told me his dad is already settled there in Maine near where Jeff's daughter is. And so all things are well there, but we certainly continue to lift them in prayer. We celebrate the opportunity to continue the relationship with Operation Shoestring. That has been a 40-year blessing or more. But what a blessing it is to reconnect, to share life together, and to continue to help shape and form the life, not only of the kids at Operation Shoestring, but at Wells as well. And what a great opportunity it is for us and for them. But we offer our prayers for this week and all of the adjustments and all of the adaptability and all of those things that will take place to make it a great event for everyone. I encourage your prayers and would solicit your prayers also for a sports camp that is taking place in Morton, Mississippi. The pastor there, along with a few lay people, decided that the best thing they could do was to get involved in the greater community in a way. And instead of hosting the grandchildren that would come and a few kids that would come to Vacation Bible School in their church building, they're sponsoring a sports camp and invited the school officials and coaches to be a part of that with them. But there's one logistics pastor who's a bit nervous at the moment. Because it starts tomorrow, and I don't think that I'm going to be able to leave Morton this week because I have been assigned several tasks already. They signed up, and over 200 kids have signed up for this camp. And so they're excited about that. Probably around 225 to 230 will actually be present. And so, but again, please pray for the logistics-minded pastor who doesn't think everything's in place yet. So that it will all go well. But we lift that up. We lift up the family of Sue Peters. Miss Sue's graveside service was this past Tuesday. And we want to lift her family up. And we miss her, Mark Williman and I, as we visited Julia Cloy the other day. Remembered all of the friends who sat along those pews there with them, and a lot of them are not able to be with us. We give thanks. Julia's doing well and is at home, and continue to pray for her. However, lift her up. We had a great visit there. We also pray for the family of Terry Johnson. Pam Johnson had mentioned that to us, and who passed away on June the 6th. And DT had mentioned to me that Robert and Jack Mann's mother passed away, Frances Mann, and today, her service will be today in Carthage at the Carthage Methodist Church there with interment in the Jordan Family Cemetery. So we lift up the Mann family as well this morning. Pray for our friend, Loran Buchanan. She's out of the hospital and doing okay and making some transitions, but we lift her up in our prayers this day. As we pray, we pray for George McDonald, for Wendell Collins, for Terry Johnson. Jane and Ed Streets, we continue to lift up in their journeys with cancer treatments and the other things that are taking place. Great to see John Gressley with us and appreciate the friends who are here with him that have helped get him here today, and we appreciate that. Good to see you. My friend Beth Edmonston, who had surgery this week, is doing well and is back at home, but continue to lift her up and some follow-up that may have to take place. Also, we continue to pray for Carr Jones, Miss Annie's son, as we pray. For Clifton Jackson, we continue to pray also. Also this morning, I'm looking for where I typed it in. Wendell Collins, we want to pray for. Miss Elaine's husband, who's having some health concerns, and pray for him today as well. We're grateful that Jean is here, and we pray for her and Steve Rosman, and continue to keep them in our prayers also. I'm sorry, Jean, go ahead. Okay, well, blessings. Hopefully there's been some healing in your prayers for that. Yeah. Wade Greeno, Steve Greeno's great nephew, is to have surgery in the middle of June. I got this neat picture from Steve's brother Mark, who's the grandfather of he and Wade together, and asked us to be praying. I think it's like the 17th of June that we'll be back in New Orleans with surgery. We continue to pray for Rich and Jackie McGinnis. We pray for Bill and Jane Baker. We pray for Steve Long, for Steve Knapp, for Thomas McClinton, and for John and Margaret Garner. I'm sure that there are others this morning that you would like to lift up as we pray. Yes?
One of my sweet friends started miscarrying this week and had to have a procedure Friday to kind of help her body finish that process, but both health-wise and just emotionally, just a real hard week.
Yeah. Yeah, Bob?
Rebecca Stark-Sachs, she has a fractured back.
Okay. Yeah, John?
My sister-in-law, Kay Culliver Gunner, was transferred from the hospital to an assisted living center in Gulfport called Clyburn. And if y'all could pray for her,
okay.
Pray for that.
Absolutely. Mark?
I have a family member that begins cancer treatment tomorrow.
Okay. Yeah. Yes.
Prayer of Thanksgiving for a close friend's son who had surgery on both of his legs 2.5 weeks ago. The surgery went well.
Great, thank you. Yes.
My friend Tisha McClendon is still undergoing cancer treatments, chemo and radiation.
Okay.
Continue to pray. Thanks for your prayers for Glenda. She continues to heal. And then for the family of Nell Huff, who passed away this week at age 95.
Yeah. I'd asked Greg Campbell this morning, it was his fingers and all working, and whether they are or not, he's still snapping pictures. So I think there's a little numbness we're praying that will go away, but he's doing good. Greg, did you have some others?
Yeah.
Okay. Great.
And also, the Parkinsons are up visiting Lane's Craig.
That's right. That's right. That's right. That's great. Thank y'all for joining us today, virtually. Yes, Andy. Certainly. Yeah, Rosemary? Yes.
Margaret Pike said, pray for the families of Terry Johnson and Mary Henderson who passed away. They both passed away this week.
Okay. Thank you, Margaret. Okay.
I got a couple. Perry S. in recovery in college.
Okay.
Jan?
Yes, I'm sorry, Jan.
My good friend Jill McCluskey had surgery this week. She's home, but just pray for recovery.
Church Council meets today after worship and doing some great work in preparation of transitions. Pray for that and for them. Pray for Reverend Susanna Grubb's car. I want to call that name so you'll get used to hearing it and saying it. Reverend Susanna Grubb's car. She's having a great time on her leave and opportunity to renew and refresh. I talked to her briefly yesterday. Y'all get ready. Strap on. She's excited and anxious, and it's going to be a great transition. And she's so thrilled to be a part of this journey with you. And so she's going to bring a new energy that this 61-year-old doesn't have anymore. And I'm afraid of what that may do when those two get together, but blessings on all of you as you journey forward. Now, we do pray for that transition. We pray for Susanna and Todd and for their two sons as they make the transition here. And so we look forward to that. Any other prayer concerns? We know that God hears our hearts and that God walks with us on our journeys. And yet we offer ourselves to God's presence even now as we offer these concerns to Him. Will you join me as Sue comes to pray?
Would you pray with me? Most gracious and loving God of us all, we thank you for the opportunity to come into this place and to worship you today. God, we're thankful for your presence that meets us here, that works in and through and with each of us. And God, we are grateful for the glimpses that we get of you as we look into the eyes of one another. God, you bless us so much. You shower your love on us each and every day. God, may we seek to notice that love. And may we seek to always say thank you for all the gifts that you give us. God, this day we lift up those that we know who are sick. God, where there can be healing, would you offer it? We lift up those who are hungry. God, would you give them food? And would you help us to be your hands and feet to feed them? God, we pray for those who are journeying through life without shelter, especially as the days get warmer. God, would you give them protection, and would you give them hope for a new day? God, we pray for all of those who are seeking meaningful work. God, for those looking for a living wage. God, would you provide that work that each of us need? And would you continue to provide all of our needs, even those that we are too afraid to ask for? God, would you continue to be with each of us in this place and outside of this place. Would you continue to call us to be your servants? And would you continue to lead us into serving? God bless us this week as we partner with Operation Shoestring for Vacation Bible School. God, keep us safe, keep us happy, keep us healthy. And God, would you bring your spirit of fun as well? We pray for Reverend Susanna as she prepares to come and to be with us. God, would you continue to give her vision for this place? And would you continue to sustain her and the energy that she will bring? And God, we also pray for Chris as he begins to transition away from this place. Would you bring him strength to finish his time here well? And God, would you bring him peace as he goes to Morton and spends some time there? God, we're thankful for all of the many blessings, especially the blessings of this place and our pastors. And God, we're thankful for the blessing of each other. Please be with us. We pray all these things in the name of Christ, who taught us to pray, by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
We continue to seek to do our part by offering our gifts and our time and talents to God. And so we pray God's blessing upon the gifts that we offer this day. Amen. Thank you.
invite you to remain standing and turn in your hymnal to pages 853 and 854 as we join together in our shared reading. We will be reading Psalm 138 this morning. I give you thanks, O Lord, with my whole heart. Before the gods, I sing your praise.
I bow down toward your holy temple and give thanks to your name for your steadfast love and faithfulness.
For you have exalted your name and your word above everything.
On the day I called, you answered me. You strengthened my life.
All the rulers of the earth shall praise you, O Lord.
For they have heard the words of your mouth.
And they shall sing of the ways of the Lord.
For great is the glory of the Lord.
For the Lord is high, but regards the lowly.
Yet knows haughty from afar.
Though I walk in the midst of trouble, you preserve my life.
You stretch out your hand against the wrath of my enemies, and your right hand delivers me.
O Lord, fulfill your purpose for me.
O Lord, may your steadfast love endure forever. Do not forsake the work of your hands.
Amen. I invite you to continue standing and join in your small hymnal, The Faith We Sing. Turn in your small hymnal to The Faith We Sing as we sing together, Glorify Their Name, on page 2016.
Share together the gospel lesson for today, which comes from Matthew's gospel, chapter 16, verses 24 through 26. Then Jesus told his disciples, "If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it. And those who lose their life for my sake will find it. For what will it profit them if they gain the whole world but forfeit their life? Or what will they give in return for their life?" It's the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. You may be seated. Please join me as we pray. Lord, we give you thanks for your word. Today's gospel challenges us. What does it mean to save our life and lose it for the sake of Jesus? And yet you called us to have open ears and open eyes and open hearts to hear what it is you want to say to us. So God, speak through me and help me to say what you want said. We pray it in the name of Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, as we ventured into these last days, last Sundays together, I've suggested to you that where God led me was to talk about making an investment, doing my part, and to talk about the commitment we make to Christ and the church as we offer ourselves to become members of the church or a part of a growing community of faith. We've talked about what it means to give of our prayers and our presence. Last week, we took that diversion and talked about gifts, our time, our talents, and yes, our money, as we share life together and as we share in God's call for what He's calling us to be and do. One of the things I suggested to you is that as we make a commitment to Jesus Christ, as we experience God's grace in our hearts for our own, and we begin to turn to follow Jesus, that one of those things it calls us to do is to continue to grow in our life of faith, to not become stagnant in who we are, but to continue to seek where Christ is, to continue to chip away those things that do not look like Jesus in us, so that we may reflect the image of Christ more fully in how we live and in who we are. That doesn't take away our individuality. It doesn't take away our individual gifts and hearts, but it just enhances them by helping us to reflect Jesus in the many, many ways that Jesus wants to be reflected in this world as we live out His love. Today we're going to talk about service and witness. We're called to go beyond the simple sense of growing in our faith to giving back to what to the people and to the world that God has called us to be in and to minister to. We've talked about worship and prayers and presence. We've talked about growing in our faith and our gifts, and so our lives having a purpose and a trajectory in Christ, and we continue to grow in that relationship with God and continue to share in that. Today we talk about what it means to give of our very selves. Once we begin to reflect the image of Christ, we're called to do that not only among the people who gather together in a place, but to do that in the world as we share this grace and love of God with others. Jesus said to His disciples in Matthew 16, you're called to deny yourself and take up your cross and follow me. Too often we get tied up in what's good for me and what's good for us. I know it seems I'm being very, very selfish in retiring and leaving you after 5 years. But I promise you there's been much, much prayer. Those who've journeyed with me closely know that since 2001, January 2001, I've prayed about whether this day would come. God gave us the date of June 2024 in 2021, and since then, Sheila and I have checked ourselves. We have monitored our own life of faith and our own call. We have checked our financial forecast to be sure this is still a possibility. But we've also really prayed, God, is this the time? And I'm not sure what God's up to in our lives, but I have a feeling that God will be doing something and that we will be in service and witness. Bill Gray asked me last week after the service if I was going to go back to Costa Rica and lead any teams to Costa Rica. And I said to Bill, well, you know, if I'm hanging out at coffee shops and bars, if there's a group of people decides they want to go, I'll take them. So if you want to go, look at me up. I have a feeling there will be opportunities to witness this love and grace of Christ in ways that I haven't had the opportunity to in 40 years. And I look forward to that. And yes, God continues to affirm that this is my call for you in this season. We each have to kind of listen for God's call of how to live out this life of service. Some of us live it out of a sense of responsibility. Some of us were called to that, and we grew up with that, that, you know, when you went to church, you dressed in a particular way. You went there so many times a week. You also contributed in certain ways, and one of those was to give of your service. Amen. And thank you. And your witness. We're going to get to witness in a minute, because I think we've misused that word a little bit that I want to talk more about. A friend of mine, when I was at First Methodist Church in Lewisdale, Mississippi, gave me an identifying name for some of those people. There are some people who will show up at the church no matter what you're doing or how. He called them the brick counters. I said, "What do you mean, Jeff, by brick counters?" He said, "You know, it's those people that if you called a meeting to count the bricks on the outside of the church, they're going to show up and be a part of that and help you do it." Thank God for the brick counters. Those who will show up and do it. But we're all called, not just out of a sense of obligation, but we're all called to respond to God with who we are and what we have. And a part of that is to be in service. On the night Jesus knew he was leaving, one of the things that he did was to show his disciples what it meant to serve. And he reminded them that that call to service is important. We're called to be people who transform the world for Jesus Christ. And the way we transform the world for Jesus Christ is that we begin to act and live like Jesus in the world around us and offer Jesus to that world so it can be transformed. Oftentimes, service fits into our gifts. My friend Bill Coos, who was with me in Out the Woods, was Mr. Habitat for Humanity. I was able to be with him when Bill worked on his 100th house. He lived in, so we were in South Jackson. For some, it was thrift shops. For some, it's Tuesday ministries. It's being present. For some, it fits right into the well of who they are. For some, it's visioning and marketing and getting that word out there that God is at work here and being a part of that, even though it may look different than what people expect. But that witness begins to play itself out. When we begin to serve God, we become doers of God's word, and we live out that. Singing in the choir. I looked up to Jamie after the anthem this morning, and I said, "I'm going to miss that. I'm going to tell you one more time. You don't know how blessed you are in this congregation. Not only by what the choir does, but by the fact that during the offertory, a James Taylor sing-along may break out." I trust you, that don't happen just everywhere. But it's real and it's authentic. And it's the very presence of God. Thank you. I'll say this again next week. But thank you for your gifts and for using them in the way you do. Working with children is a true gift, whether you're teaching or whether you're hosting Operation Shoestring Kids, or whether you're coming along to be a part of making them all have fun, or being there to teach them the ways of Jesus. Those are gifts, and it fits right naturally into many. Cooking. I mean, Sue's gift is hospitality, cooking. If y'all haven't figured that out yet, she can throw a party in a minute. And now she's got Ann Cardis on board. All she has to do is make a phone call. And the party just got expanded. And there are others, Sarah, and others who will fall right in there and be there to make that happen. It's that kind of using our gifts that makes the impact in this world. Caring for a beautiful garden in the midst of a community that's begun to deteriorate. And there's fruit and vegetables. And many of you came and helped Lori trim that up and shape that up this week. Using those gifts to make that, to be of service, but to also be a witness to the world around us of God's grace and goodness. There is a risk involved in service. We are called to acknowledge our fear and choose to live by love, because service sometimes leads us to places we are not comfortable being. But Jesus is both there. My biggest nightmare is to have 35 kids in the second grade. And yet my wife's told me, this is what you're doing this week. Y'all need to pray for those kids. And for me. And yet that's where God's placed me. Where's God placing you? And let me just say a word about our witness. So it was 2006 or so when the United Methodist Church in its wisdom decided to add to the membership vows of becoming United Methodist not only prayers, presence, gifts, and service, which I got really accustomed to sharing, and that just flowed out, just like my words of communion flow out. It's just there. But they added witness. And the importance of, in all that you do, recognizing that you are a disciple of Jesus Christ and called to be a witness. That doesn't mean taking your Bible and going out on the street corner and shouting at people like they do at parades in neighborhoods. We were simply trying to be welcoming and supporting of people. That doesn't mean, for me, I used to get this image growing up in South Mississippi. We got this image from all of our Baptist friends who went to New Orleans Seminary to go down and stand on the street corners and witness all those sinners walking down those streets down there. Y'all know which one I'm talking about. It's much deeper than that. It's been so co-opted that those who are professional Christian witnesses now believe they have all of it wrapped up in a little package and can just spout to you what it is. And if you don't believe it like they say it is and understand it like they understand it to be, then there's no way you're going to be a Christian. I've been going to hell since I was a youth. Because I wouldn't let my friends push me in a corner to say, you've got to speak in tongues to really have the Holy Spirit. I said, oh, really? If you're not this particular denomination, then there's no chance you've got. And if you're going to stay United Methodist, you are surely going straight to where the devil lives. Did y'all notice I didn't say hell? But that's what they're talking about. I've been told that more than once, and dang, if they're not from my own denomination now telling me I'm going to do the same thing. Witnessing is not sharing about Jesus Christ because you're right or that you have the answers, because it leads you into a big step of judgment real quick. Witnessing is offering the love of Jesus Christ in such a way that you don't have to say a word. That people will see in and through you a presence that is so different that it compels them to ask you what it is. It's okay to mention the name of Jesus. And if a street corner is where God leads you, bless you. But please don't preach down to people. Offer them transformation. Offer them Jesus Christ, not condemnation. Let me just say that in the era of social media, people know who you are and what your witness is. I got in real trouble at one church who is no longer United Methodist for simply loving a post of a fellow pastor who had found a place to be able to serve Jesus Christ and was serving communion, and he had a picture saying, "Thanks be to God." And some people blew the picture up and found some person dressed like they didn't like and told me that was blasphemous. And I said, "I'm just loving my friend. And I'm grateful that my friend is able to be a witness for Jesus Christ in a place that I never could. In a way that I never could." So as you cut and paste and love or like or pass on your social media posts, please remember that you're a witness for Jesus Christ. And for a relationship with the God who cares for you and wants you to live in a relationship and live out that relationship with Him wherever you go. Yes, there is some accountability in the midst of this. God does call us to live transformed lives. But it's not a cookie cutter pattern for everybody of what they're to look like and be. We're called to be a witness. Often, as we continue to make an investment and do our part, remember that it's not only you experiencing God's grace and being transformed, but it's how not only you give, but how you live your life that's important to Jesus. And we're called to be servants and witnesses of Jesus Christ. I encourage you to allow Jesus to transform your life in such a way that you may know His grace and show His grace wherever you are. One of the things that's often been said is as we begin to look at our priorities of life and how we're really living, to look at your bank account and your calendar, and it will show you where you place the emphasis of your life and your priority. Maybe it's a good time to visit there, to pray for God's guidance and strength as we move forward. Well, I told you already that next week the Coral Reefer Band's coming back. So if that's a concern for you, then it's okay. But I invite you to join me as we celebrate. Because one of the things that I think we don't do enough of is enjoy life and our relationships together. And to give thanks to the God who offers us life. So I'm wearing flip-flops and blue jeans. I always dreamed I could end my ministry that way. So join me as we share life together. May you make an investment, because God needs you. And God needs you here at Wells. Whoever you are. And God wants you to do your part as we journey together. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. We give thanks that on the night Jesus gave Himself up for us, He took bread and broke it. And He gave it to His disciples and said, "Take and eat, this is My body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of Me." after the supper, he took the cup and he blessed it. He said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood, the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. It's because of these mighty acts in Jesus Christ that we are invited to this table to come and experience God's grace, to come and be challenged by God's presence, to come and be empowered to go forth to live out this word in the world. Will you join me as we pray? Oh Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and wine, make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. Through your Spirit, make us one with Christ and one with each other, and one in unity to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Well, those who are going to assist me, please come and join me. All things are ready, and you're invited to come and partake. Thank you.
Anyone else
serve where you are? Let's stand and sing. If y'all just feel the need to come gather around the altar, that's up to you. But we can sing it with you.